So, you want to be a high-value man? Well, unfortunately for you, I am not the Godfather, so you clicked on the wrong video. But you did click on this video because you want a high-value beard. And you're in the right place, baby. In this video, we're going to talk about the five commandments of a high-value beard. Let's kick it off with number one right now. What's going on, YouTube? My name is Hef, your bearded brother, that guy on YouTube with a beard. And in today's video, we're gonna just jump right into it. The number one commandment of a high value beard. Well, your beard must be bodacious. Now, forewarning you, I'm gonna be hitting you with them SAT words this entire video. But it's all good because we got our friend Webster's Dictionary helping us out the entire way. Now let's look at this definition for bodacious. Excellent, admirable, or attractive. The restaurant serves bodacious grilled lobster. Now I don't know about y'all, but I personally can't stand lobster. But that's not even the point of this commandment. Now, when I think of a bodacious beard, someone that quickly comes to mind is like LeBron James. He has the genetics for a bold, thick, evenly growing beard, and that satisfies the first commandment of a high-value beard. It has to be bodacious. Now, our second high-value beard commandment is ear to ear. Now, unfortunately for some of you guys, there's no way around it. If you want a high value beard, it has got to connect. You can't be out here looking like Ludacris in his roll out and throwing them bows days and expect to have a high value beard. Now, you guys remember that movie 300? You had the leader, Leonidas of the Spartan army. And then you had a little monster looking dude who wanted to join the army. And then remember what Leonidas told him when the little monster was auditioning for the army.
Each Spartan protects the man to his left, thigh to neck with his shield. A single weak spot and the phalanx shatters. From thigh to neck. Fealties. I am sorry, my friend, but not all of us were made to be soldiers.
Thigh to neck, same as ear to ear. Thigh to neck, ear to ear. Now, if you're enjoying the video so far, feel free to give me that thumbs up, and let's head straight into high value beard commandment number three. A high-value beard has to be alluring. Let's hit up Webster's Dictionary again to help us out. Alluring, powerfully and mysteriously. Attractive or fascinating. Seductive, the town offers alluring shops and restaurants. All in all, a high-value, alluring beard should be able to enhance your natural sex appeal. A good example of this that comes to mind, they say this is a big rich town. I just come from the poorest part. That's right. We talking about Mr. Ghost himself, James St. Patrick. He has what I would consider an alluring beard. Now, this is not your excuse to run off to New York City, start a nightclub called Truth, running narcotics all under the basement-ish. Let's tone it down a little bit, guys. But that is an alluring beard, and that is our third high value beard commandment. Next up, number four, a high value beard must be robust, strong and healthy, vigorous, sturdy in construction. Now, when it comes to a robust beard, a high value robust beard, two people right off the bat comes to mind. Number one, we got Mr. James Harden himself. And then number two, we got Hef right here, man. Me and James Harden are the robust beard kings of the tri-state area, baby. A robust beard simply shows, you know, the testosterone is working well, it's pumping through the body, your blood flow is right, and that it overall shows that you are a healthy, functioning, red-blooded man. And that if you can grow a robust beard, it's a sign of health and virility in men. And lastly, our final high-value beard commandment, your beard must be distinctive. A characteristic of one person or thing, and so serving to distinguish it from others. The net of it, it kind of just means it's like your trademark. You're known for that distinctive beard style. Now, the perfect example for a distinctive beard, and to be honest, the perfect way to end this list, is the Godfather himself, Mr. High Value, Mr. K-Sam. He has a very distinct beard style. He has the stubble look with the gray in it. And to be honest, he's the number one guy that rocks this look. It's kind of his trademark. And that is a perfect example of a distinctive beard and a distinctive high-value beard. Now, let's do a quick recap of the five high-value beard commandments. Number one, your beard must be bodacious. Think LeBron, bold, even, thick. Number two, ear to ear. No struggles, no patches. A high value beard has got to connect. Think Ludacris back in the day. Number three, your beard must be alluring. Think Mr. James St. Patrick from Power. Number four, a high value beard, must be robust. Have a lot of volume. Show that you're a healthy, healthy young man. Think James Harden. Think Mr. Bearded Hefner himself. Last but not least, your beard must be distinctive. What is your trademark? Do you have a distinctive look about you? Think about Mr. Kevin Samuels, how he rocks his salt and pepper, or to be honest, it's more just salt, low stubble beard. That is the high, that is the five high value beard commandments. Now drop me a comment if you're high value or you have a high value beard. I want to hear from you guys either way. Lastly, I'm trying out a new beat in the outro. I'm going to hit y'all with it right now. Let me know if y'all feeling it or if I should go back to the old beat. Until next time, it's your boy, Bearded Hefner. Peace!